So you got your phone out and recorded some video in the vertical mode, and then when you went to edit it and put it into a normal 16:9 timeline, you realize that you have these big black bars on the side and you hate the way it looks. You don't want all that empty space and trying to figure out, how do I conform my vertical video to a horizontal format? Let's take a look at how to do this in your editing software. I'm using Final Cut Pro, but whatever you're using, a similar process will work. The first thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna make my project, call it vertical video fix. I've got a 16:9 format in 4K, and then I'm going to drag my vertical video into the timeline. And as we can see, let's mute that. We have all this black space, not something we wanna have in the video. So if you were to just take this and do something like a spatial conform, well now you lose a lot of the video, the top and bottom, and I watch it and it's like, well, I'm out of frame on the bottom, on the top. I could move it some. In this case, I mean, this video is actually so far away that you can almost get everything in there. But for most videos, that's not the case. So what can we do to make it look a little better without all the black space? For me, I'm gonna hit Command C on my MacBook and then Command V. I'm gonna layer these two so that one is right on top of the other one. And what I'm gonna do is take the bottom one and then I'm going to conform that one to the whole screen. So now that's in the background, but it looks kind of weird. So what I'm gonna do now is type in Gaussian for a Gaussian blur. And this, you can control how blurry it is. I'm gonna take the amount down to what I like. So just enough so it's not really too distracting. And this is what you see a lot of people do in online videos and news stories or something. When there's vertical video, they show it like this. So now it's basically seeing the same thing behind it. It's not just black space. It's not the best looking thing, but it still works. And in the case of this video, since it is so wide, I could actually make another copy of that and layer that underneath. And then I could take one of these and move it over to the left so that I'm in view on one side, and then take out the right. And then on the left one, I can move them as well. So in the background, you can see each of us individually. It just depends on what you want. It works out for this. But with videos like this, if you did want to make this one bigger, it doesn't have to stay in the completely vertical format since there's so much room above and below. I can make it more of a square look like this, and it still works fine. So let's take a look at one more video that might not work quite as well like this because you're taking up the whole frame and don't have so much empty space on the top and bottom. All right, so here we have a little video of my 2-year-old at Chick-fil-A eating some ice cream when she started singing a song before she ate her ice cream. So once again, if we were to take this and just conform it to the screen, that's not really how I want my video to look because her face is massive now and it doesn't work out for the video. So once again, copy, paste, we layer it. I'll take the volume down on one of them so it's not twice as loud. Take the bottom one and now conform that one. And that does look kind of weird without the blur. So we'll put that in again and just put it to an amount that makes sense for you. Around 20 usually works pretty well. And let's see how that looks. So now at least if you were gonna post this video somewhere where you had a horizontal format, it looks a little bit better and doesn't have just all these black lines like that. A little bit more visually interesting and make your video look better. So that's how I do it. Let me know what editing program you're using. If you have any questions, it's basically copy, paste, layer the two, enlarge the bottom layer, blur it, and that's it. Export it, you're good to go. But if this was helpful, hit that like button. Subscribe if you're new. Leave comments with whatever you want, hopefully something nice, and I'll see you all in the next one.